Well, I think my partner, Jim Dixon, who's been a lawyer here in town for many years, he and I always admired the building. And then in the year 2000, the city decided that they didn't want to support it anymore and they were going to put it up for sale. So Jim and I jumped in and ended up acquiring the building in April of 2001.
Coal chutes.
Well, yeah, the Robert Raymond Cook story. One reason that this building is a designated historical resource by the province of Alberta is that this was the last courthouse in Alberta in which somebody was sentenced to death and was ultimately hung, and that was Robert Raymond Cook. He was convicted in 1959 of killing his father, his stepmother, and five step-siblings. And in those days, you did that and you hung.
He said, what I do know is that he went to the gallows believing in his own innocence.
Well, it goes, you know, I think it's started way back in the 1950s where it started to outgrow the place. And then in 1958, there was an addition put on. If you look at the northeast corner, there's a flat roof addition there. And that gave it a few more years, but nevertheless, it was still outgrowing it. And then I believe the building that was next door, where Bishop Drugs is now, I believe that was used as a courthouse for some time. And finally, they completed the new courthouse in 1983. And now, ironically, I understand that one's being outgrown too. So we just, I guess the need for this sort of thing just keeps on growing over time, and as the city gets larger as well.
Been in here about 6 months or so, and I got a call from the police to say our tree had fallen across 49th Avenue.
Not really. We may hoist a glass of something tonight, nothing formal at all. In 16 years, if we're still around, we'll be at 100, and we may have a real humdinger of a party then. And as you've noticed, of course, we've taken down the modern Canadian flag and put up the then Canadian flag. That'll be up for the weekend. The red Ensign flag, which was Canada's flag in 1931.